Self-defense. Now we're gonna go with 20 different strike points real quick. Ground side control, shield defense from a haymaker, and with two counter strikes, defense from attacker while sitting on the ground, both palm strikes and kicks, okay? You've already done these, I'm pretty much sure that there's just repeats, so you can get practice more repetition. All right, 20 different strike points. All right, you send me a fighting stance or attacker stance. Okay, remember now, each shin, one, two, three, four, knees, five, or straight in, six, straight back, seven, inside, eight, nine, out, 10. Intercostals, that's the ribcage, 11. Ridge hand there is 12. It doesn't matter what it is. Ridge hand, elbow, side elbow strike. Those are still there. What am I at? 13 or 14? 15, 16, solar plexus, 17, palm strike. It doesn't matter what you're doing. Elbow strike, side elbow strike here. All right, that's still 17 or 18. That doesn't make any difference. Side of the neck, ridge hand. Could be a chop. Could be an elbow strike there. Could be to the chin. I'm already at 20 because they're going this side. Then you got double hooking palm heel, single palm heel, eyes. We haven't even got to the back. You can come around and step back this way. No, I'm sorry. You're just stepping back, side kick down. Makes them bend down. Or if you've got them running, you get to kick them back this way. Now, if you did a knee strike or uppercut and are bending over, you got one here, one here, one here. I'm not a real big fan of bladder punches and kidney punches. They don't cause the immediate effect that you really want. When all else fails, these are real sensitive points. Hitting that bone, that top of your rib cage, right in your armpit. If the arms are up high for something, like they've done a block, and you go ahead, you go boom, or knuckle or spear hand right in here. Your fingers will roll. It's going to cause severe pain temporarily. Of course, each eye is one, so there's already the two. I never said anything about punching. I'm not a big fan of self-defense punching. Palm striking, hit with a bigger area, less chance of your hand sliding off, you hit with more of an impact. And if you really look into the rules of UFC fighting, they don't allow palm striking. Not at all, because it's it is that powerful. So I went through quickly. Now, why do we have to know so many? Because these targets are not always open. If this person's twisted, I can't get to but one here, one here, one here. It'd be a little tough to get the elbow strike. This way I could get it. Palm strike here, I could get it. Palm strike this way, turning them. I could get to the intercostals here. I could get to the knee. I can't get the other side of the body. I can't get to the solar plexus. Where would you get to the groin from here if he's twisted because of the way I've turned him? Or the self-defense situation, things got turned around. They're always there. You just got to know when to hit, how fast to hit. It's in a self-defense situation. Hit first, hit often, hit fast. Kind of a strange thing to say, but that's true. Now, we're going to go into ground side control. We're going to do this quickly. We've redone this. Go ahead and hit this way, just down your back. Ground side control. Your hands back. I'm sorry, this one's going to be in here. This one's going to be around here. Remember doing this? Elbow in here. Okay, this prevents them from, one thing, hitting you, if you've got to have your elbow right in their hip and your cupped on action on their bicep, they can't, if they try to get hold of your head, they can't push it to the knee because they can't get it there. You can't even try it. Now, if there's something an object out here is trying to grab, you can just go out there like this, and, you know, a rock, a bottle, here, lock both hands in, now you can use an elbow strike to the head three or four times. This is mainly meant for guys. Women are not normally going to be in this position, especially the guys, okay? This is a better self-defense position if you're, you know, if you know anything about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, than just being up here and locking this person down around the neck works much more effectively. Now, it also keeps them from biting. If they're trying to bite you, you just turn your shoulder right in and push. You're just torquing your body and pushing your shoulder right into the jawline. They can't get you. Now, if they try to strike you with the other knee, you can just scissor this way and they'll be hitting on your back. Now you're free to do this. They may try to block you. You still got your fingers to the eyes, okay? Now, another good thing about this position is if this person now tries to get your eyes, you can bury your own. Stop. That is a real situation in the street. If it's a real violent situation, they're going to try to get your eyes. They're going to be trying to bite you. That's kind of a normal street tactic, okay? I'm real close to the body. my chest is right down. If you know anything about it, or you've practiced it a little bit, you got your control is down here, you put your weight on them. Now, if they're trying to grab, you know, something like a boot knife, you can keep them from, or a gun down there, you can do the same thing. They can't get to it. They can pull their foot back, but they can't get to it. And this is where you just strike them again. Now, also you have the ability to do knee striking on the other side. Knee here. Breaking ribs. You're in a much better control situation when you're in this position, okay? Ground side control. You got defense against the knee, defense against the knee, defense against biting, defense against eye gouging. That hand trying to pick up a rock, bottle, gravel, or whatever, it's dirt, just throw it in your face. You can keep them from doing that. You have a couple different strike points. You don't want to stay down here with them. Once you've slightly disoriented this person, you get up as fast as you can. How do you do that? You do it like this. You just jump off, putting your hands on it and pushing away. All right, that's ground side control for street self-defense. That's not what we use if you're doing some basic jiu-jitsu or Brazilian jiu-jitsu or MMA fighting in here. We don't use that one for that. It can be, but it's different, a little bit different. All right, now, the elbow shield from the wild swing haymaker, if he's going to throw a right hand punch, okay? I block, elbow shield. Remember doing this? Elbow steps in. This is my left foot, left elbow. Right? This is left hand, right hand. Hand comes up. Remember the dead arm block? Elbow. You can do eyes, this, knee. You want to try to keep your knee as close as they can to theirs if you've forgotten that, because they can't knee strike you there. All right, elbow strike, hand palms, palms, side elbow strikes. Remember the 20 different strike points we just went over? You got all possibilities there. That was the elbow shield. One sticking right in the sternum, the other one's a dead arm block, depending on which arm they want to use. And if he's, throw a right hand punch because it's better for the camera. Remember now, I'm stepping in to control this person's momentum. I got something that looks like a front stance. It doesn't have to be. The leg, back leg's fairly straight. Their energy's going into the ground. And that, when they run into that elbow, severe pain. All right, now we're going to go into defense from attacker while sitting on the ground. Kicks and palm strikes, okay? Move back far enough where everybody can see everything, correct? If you're just sitting here, I don't care if you've got both legs out, or you cross legs, or you're sitting like this. If you're sitting like this, you have the advantage if they start reaching for you here. He's already out of balance. Drag grab, right? What I mean by palm strike is knocking this knee inward. It twists them. It doesn't take a hard strike, and if you're practicing in class, it really doesn't damage the knee. It makes them just basically throws them off balance. You don't have to torque your body, you just pop the energy into the side of the knee. Now try not to fall down, but put a little bit of weight this time, right? Like you put both hands on me this time. It really makes you feel miserable. See, now I know he's got a lot of weight on that leg. From there, you can just come back and just kick him out. There's your kicks. All right, I'm hitting his knee inward. Now, if he is standing 2 feet side by side, if he's going to try to punch me, that's just ridiculous. I can just drop back, right? Okay. If I drop back, I might go ahead and just try to punch. I didn't mean to do that. Sorry, sir. I'm just defending against the punch. I just come back and hit him in here. I'm in total control here. All right, I can just smash his leg one side or the other, kick him in the face. What if I can't? It doesn't have sleeves. Okay, doesn't have sleeves. Everybody got t-shirts. Here, boom, chest. I'm heel striking, all right? You can strike him in the groin. He's in a bad. If he's standing there, I don't even. I want to just boom. Think about it. Real quick. I don't care if I'm sitting like this. Now, if I'm just sitting down like this, this is even better. I can just hook the leg, push on the knee, at the knee, right at the knee. Doesn't have to be in. Just push scissor motion, and you trip. Doesn't take a lot of power. Takes just a little bit of practice, and you know. It could be this leg, it could be the other side, it could be, you know. And it's just leveraging, especially if he's trying to reach for you now. Now, when you're practicing, down here, do not do this for your partner's safety. Try to just bring this leg forward. Stall. I'm putting pressure. I put my foot there and then I pushed. Do not hook the foot and then stomp. You're not allowed to destroy this man or person's woman's leg. So it just you just feel for the shin, you know where the knee is, and just push back. Oh, so lightly. If you don't believe it, have somebody do it on you. It's just that easy. So if everything goes wrong, he's up here and he doesn't trip, boom, there's the groin or in the midsection. This will work just as well at the hip. Okay? 20 different strike points, get to know them. 20, 30 of them, there's actually more than that. Elbow shield from a haymaker, the big wild swinging punch. Defense on the ground, there's a couple, multiple things that you can do. Very easy to do. Are you ever going to get tacked on the ground? You never know. It just gives you an option. And what type, well, I'm trying to stick to something that's realistic. If somebody's going to come up to you, they may try kicking you. They're going to be really off balance. And all you have to do is basically lay down on them and they'll miss you. They might fall on themselves going like that. Besides that, then you've got your feet up in their midsection or their groin area. Then you can knock them over. Most people don't know how to kick. They're off balance. They start grabbing for you, they're already off balanced. They're already got the weight on the balls of their feet reaching over to get you. They're trying to punch you, it's just, well, I'm just bobbing and weaving. You just lay back, get your feet up, and hit them with your feet. Feet are great things that work from the ground, okay? Especially for women in their self-defense. Now, that was pretty much everything in the self-defense section. Now, Mr. Martin.